Boy, that had show in the grandstand last night. Californian cuss politician whole night. I say the vibe was right and the thing nice. Greetings, this is Marsha Hines-Lane signing off for Refocus in Barbados, bringing you coverage of the Trinidad and Tobago election 2015. The People's National Movement held a Calypso extravaganza in the grandstand on the historic Savannah, Queen's Park Savannah last night. It was well received by supporters. It was an interesting experience. It was an opportunity for the Calypsonians to weigh in on the issues in the election. Lots of discussion about Jack Warner, lots of discussion about the leadership of the People's Partnership. It was truly an interesting experience. We have some footage of that to bring for you to see.
Messages we sending out, but we want people to know that warning the politicians, regardless if it's Rowley, whoever it is, Kamala, we warning them to, when you go in there, do what the people want you to
do.
Yeah, because of a lot of problems, people. We facing problems today. Yeah, they say that water for all. Plenty of people ain't getting. Some of you getting it home. I see your father laugh, but you hold back your water, brother. I tell you, right about now, we're moving on. Political battle. Hey, I need some action. I only like the house tonight. Looking good, boy. I hear somebody say rattan. What are you saying, boy? Gosh, man.
Looking good.
Look, all right. You ready, people? Political battle. Next performer coming on stage is Errol. Valentine, bring him on! Ballet!
Vote for she. Beep beep, I get a cell tone.
Kamala face always on me spell full. I find it such a disgrace. So much money to spend to show Kamala face. I beg you, UNC, please give me a ease. Take Kamala face from my computer and cell phone, please.
What I say, you see she up and down on the highway. What I telling you, plain and candidly, times like these, I'm glad that I cannot see.
It boiled over last week. Just give us a little bit of a context of what happened.
Of what happened last week?
Yes.
Well, nothing that had happened the week before, actually. That, as you know, I have been involved in the politics of the United National Congress for the last 15 years. I've won 4 of the elections that we've had and lost 1. And I think that I've done very well for my constituency and my constituents. And they did not... There was a conspiracy that I would have learned of later, but for some reason or the other, they did not select me as the candidate to fight this election. Didn't give me a reason for doing it. And I thought that it was something that was unfair, and it was done in a way that it was surreptitiously done, I think, as well. So I just didn't want to be any part of it, so I resigned from the party and their politics and all of that.
So what does that mean for Gypsy going forward? You've resigned from the UNC, but does that mean that you are out of the political life of Trinidad?
Well, as you can see, I have on a PNM t-shirt, right? I haven't yet joined the PNM, but I am from a PNM family, really. I am the one who chose to be with the UNC because of my relationship with Jack Warner, and he's my relative. And he's not there, no, I am not there. But no, it's not going to be the end of my politics. I think I have some political contribution to make in Trinidad and Tobago still, and I will do my best to do that.
What does Trinidad and Tobago need politically? What does this country need?
Trinidad and Tobago need a government in Trinidad and Tobago that will do things for the people and do it for the people's sake and not for self-aggrandization. They need to do things and spend the money wisely so that if something costs $1 million, let it cost $1 million. Not that something that's going to cost $1 million, but because somebody is going to get $2 or $3 or $4 million, they say that whatever is going to cost $1 million is going to cost $4 million. Because yes, we do a lot of things, but a lot more can be done if the money was spent wisely. And I hope that the next government, because I know there will be a next government, and I hope that the next government that is coming in here would in fact do that. And I know Keith as well. I know the kind of personality he has. He's a one like me. You have never heard anybody talk about me involving any untoward anything in politics. It's because the honesty of doing what you're doing for the people's sake is what we need in this country.
So you're calling the election. Are you putting any numbers behind that?
Well, the election is going to be close, but at the end of the day, I know that the PNM is going to win. And I really don't care if you win by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It doesn't make a difference. As a matter of fact, if it's close, that's not bad. It's actually good for the governance in terms of keeping people doing the right thing.
Now, do you think there is going to be, I don't want to say violence, but do you think Trinidadians are prepared to accept this election, whatever the outcome is?
Well, I think we have been accepting elections, the results of elections in 1952. And I don't see any reason why we should change now. I think it's a cultural thing. And we are not culturally wired to have violence at our elections. And I'm not seeing that at all. Trinidad is a fun-loving place, actually. And at the end of the day, because of the size of Trinidad, most people know everybody and most people are related in one way or the other. And who are not really blood related has a friendship tie that is not conducive to having that kind of, you know, like political violence and stuff. So I hope that that never enters our culture, and I am not seeing it really.
Now the final question I have for you, this show tonight was an absolute treat. I've never seen anything like it, the Pekong, the rivalry between the Calypsonians and stuff. Talk to me a little bit about why the PNM puts on this show that links the politics and the culture as a part of its political campaign all the time.
Well, it's not that the PNM do that, I tell you. We are culturally wired a certain way. And what you're experiencing here is just part of Trinidad and Tobago's culture. It is what we do. It is not anything that anybody have to do. It is what we do. And why the Calypsonians have gravitated towards the PNM more than anything else, it is because the PNM have been in existence before any other political party that we have, any other entity. And Dr. Eric William was the person, and he drove that in a certain way, so it become innate almost for the Calypsonians to be a part of that political PNM political landscape.
Thank you so much for your time. I know you're a busy man.
You're
I hope you
welcome.
Enjoy the rest of the
Thank
night
you.
And good
I'll
luck.
I'll do my best.
Thank you.
Take care.
That is practice. When you take a guy with colleges and you're the Minister of Education, you know what happened? Anything you ask him, he says he's looking into you.